Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Welcome to our online class arranged by the authority of Dr. Kastugir Government Girls High School. Today I am with you, Tauhida Armana, senior teacher, Dr. Kastugir Government Girls High School, Chattogram. Hello, dear learners. How are you? Hope all of you are staying at home, safe and sound. I am also keeping well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Let's start our today's class. Today, my class is on English first paper, that is English for today, and my class is for the students of class 10. Here is the picture of your EFT book. At first, look at the picture. I think most of you are familiar with this picture. This is a picture of a mosque, isn't it? Yes, but this is not a usual mosque. You can see several domes at the top of the roof. And there are several doorways, you can see. This is a beautiful, interesting place of Bangladesh. Can you tell me the name of this place? Yes, it is the Shat Gombuj Mosque. So, our today's topic is the Shat Gombuj Mosque. You will find it in your EFT book in Unit 8, Lesson 1. And you will get it at page number 112, learning outcomes. After we have studied this lesson, we will be able to ask and answer questions, read and understand the text through silent reading, infer the meaning from the text. Okay? And we will be able to describe a place also. Have a look here. Before going through the text, I will like to introduce you with some words and their meaning. Our first word is unique. The meaning of unique is exclusive, exceptional, or distinctive. Next word is outer skirts. Meaning is borders or outer edge or environs. Our third word is mangrove. The meaning of mangrove is coastal forest. Next word, hollow, meaning empty space inside. Then our next word is remarkable. The meaning of remarkable is extraordinary, amazing, or notable. Here is a word, terracotta. The meaning of terracotta is glazed or unglazed, fired clay, or you can also say baked earth. Our last word, aisle. The meaning of aisle is passage or corridor or path or lane. These are some words. You will get this word in your text when you will go through the text. Now open your book. Here is section A. I am reading out the instruction. Look at the picture, work in pairs, talk about the picture, and ask and answer the following questions. As you are staying at home, so this is not possible for you to do pair work. So you have to do it individually. Here is the picture of a building. What is this building? You can say, I think this is the Shat Gombuj Mosque. Our next question, do you have a building like this in your town or village? How can you answer this? You can answer this like that. Yes, but it does not have so many domes. This is a mosque, But in usual mosque, there are you cannot find so many tombs. What do we call it? We can call it mosque. What is it used for? It is used for saying prayers. Okay. Next. Now come to section B. Read the text and complete the table given after it. I am reading out the text loudly, but you have to read out the text silently with me. Heritage is what we inherit from the past, live with in the present, and then pass on to our children or future generation. Our unique source of life and inspiration is our cultural and natural heritage. When we speak of world heritage, it is our cultural and natural heritage. When we speak of world heritage, it indicates places and sites that we inherited from the past and pass on to the future generation of the entire world. The Shat Gombuj Mosque in Bagerhat is such a heritage. It became a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1985. Originally, the historic mosque city was known as Khalifatabad. It is situated at the outskirts of Bagerhat town, not very far from the dense mangrove forest of the Sundarbans. Khalifatabad was a Muslim colony. It was founded by the Turkish general, a saint warrior, Uluk Khan Jahan Ali, in the 15th century. The infrastructure of the city reveals significant technical skills in many mosques as well as early Islamic monuments. Baked bricks were used for the construction of the buildings. The planning of the city was dominated by the tradition of Islamic architecture, and decorations were a combination of Mughal and Turkish architecture. Okay. Let's see a picture. This is, what can we say? This is the wooden structure of Shat Gombuj Mosque. You can see the roof of this mosque. In one row, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 domes. So there are how many rows? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 rows. So 7 elevens are 7 elevens. If we count timetable, if 7 elevens are 77 domes are here, and at four corners there are smaller domes. There are four smaller domes at four corners, and these are the doorways. Okay. This is the wooden structure of Shat Gombuj Mosque. Let's move to our next slide. Here is the text. Khan Jahan Ali built a network of roads, bridges, public buildings, and reservoirs to make the city habitable. There were about 360 mosques in the city. Among them, the most remarkable is the multi-domed Shat Gombuj Mosque. The mosque is unique in the sense that it has 60 pillars that support the roof, with 77 low-height domes. The four towers at four corners have smaller domes at the top as well. The vast prayer hall has 11 arched doorways on the east and 7 each on the north and south for light and ventilation. It has 7 aisles running along the length of the mosque and 11 deep curved between the slender stone columns. These columns support the curved arches created by the domes. The thickness of the arches is 6 feet and have slightly narrowing hollow and round wall. Let's see a picture. This is the picture of Shat Gombuj Mosque. Here is an arrow. This arrow is indicating the 77 low-height domes at the roof of this mosque. We have already seen it in our wooden structure. Here is another arrow. This arrow indicates the smaller domes in four corners. There are four smaller domes at four corners that we have already learned. There are 11 arch doorways on east. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There are 11 arch doorways on east. Okay. Let's move to another picture. This is the south of this mosque. And this is the east of this mosque. At the east side, we have already learned that there are 11 arched doorways on the east of the mosque and 7 arched doors in both south side and in its opposite side, that is north side. There are also 7 arched doorways on north side. So, on south side, there are 7 doorways, and on the north side, there are also 7 arched doorways. Okay. This is the inside the mosque. We have learned that it has 7 aisles running along the length. These are the aisles. These are the aisles length. These aisles are running along the length of the mosque and 11 deep curved. There are 11 deep curved. These are the curved between the slender column, slender stone columns. These are the slender stone columns. These are the slender stone columns. Okay. These columns, what is the function of these columns? These columns support the curving arches created by the domes. At the upside, these domes are supported by these slender stone columns. Okay. This is the inside view of the mosque. Now, again, our text. The west wall in the interior has 11 mihrabs, niche in mosque pointing towards Mecca. These mihrabs are decorated with stonework and terracotta. The floor of the mosque is made of brick. Besides being used as a prayer hall, Khanjahan Ali used the mosque as his court too. Today, it is one of the greatest tourist attractions and one of the best architectural beauties of Bangladesh. Okay. We have already learned that on the east side, there are 11 arched doorways. And in the west wall, there are 11 mihrabs. These mihrabs is pointing towards Mecca. Okay. See, the interior western wall of the mosque is beautifully decorated with terracotta. These are the terracotta, beautiful terracotta. Okay. West wall of this mosque is beautifully decorated with terracotta. Now, here is the table. Shat Gombuj Mosque. And you have to write down the information of this. Founded by whom? When it is founded? Number of domes, number of pillars, arches, thickness of the arches and mihrabs. Okay. We have already learned about this. What you have to do, you have to go through the text again and you have to collect this information and you have to write down the information in the table. Let's match your answer with me. It is founded by Khanjahan Ali when in 15th century. Number of domes, there are 77 low height domes and plus four, that is at the four corner, there are 4 domes. So I have added these 4 domes here. So in total, there are 81 domes and number of pillars, 60 pillars and arches. There are 11 arch doorways on the east and 7 plus 7 arch doorways on the north and 7 arch doorways on the south. So in total, there are 25 arches. Okay, thickness of the arches. These arches are 6 feet thick. Mihrabs, there are 11 mihrabs. We have already learned it. Have a look here. I have come to our section C. This is, what is this? This is the Star Masjid. Star Mosque. Here is the instruction. Look at the picture of the Star Mosque in Dhaka. And this is the information. Read the information and write a description of the Star Mosque with the help of the given clues. These are the clues. And this is the picture of Star Mosque. Here is a big star. And you can see several stars here, here, here. At the dome of the mosque, here also. What are the clues? Let's see. Location, Dhaka, Abdul Khairat Road, style, Mughal style, number of domes, 5 domes. You can easily calculate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 domes. Decoration, different sizes of stars on dome and outside wall. Okay. Materials used for decoration, china ware and white cement. Interior of the mosque, mosaic floor, floral tiles on the wall. Built by Mirza Ghulam Pir, a respectable jamidar of Dhaka. And time, early 18th century. Ghulam Pir, okay. Here, other picture of Star Mosque. These are the inside of this mosque. Decorations. These are the china ware and white cement and several floral mosaic. Okay. Different sizes of stars, domes, china ware, floor, mosaic floor, floral tiles. These are the floral tiles. Okay. What you have to do, you have these, by the help of these clues, you have to write a description of Star Mosque. Okay. I have prepared a description for you. Let's see. The Star Mosque, which is an architectural beauty of Mughal, is situated at Abul Khairat Road in Dhaka. It has 5 domes. There are different sizes of stars on domes and outside wall. China ware and white cement are used to building it. It has mosaic floor and floral tiles on the wall. This mosque was built by Mirza Ghulam Pir, a respectable jamidar of Dhaka. It was built in the early 18th century. Okay, I have completed the text already. So, dear students, you have to go through the text again, again and again, and you have to do this work by yourself. Okay? So, I'm at the end of my class. Thank you for watching my class. Goodbye and see you next. Allah Hafiz.